only imagine what it will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in awe of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak at all? I can only imagine. I can only imagine. I can only imagine when that day comes and I find myself standing in the sun. I can only imagine when all I will do is forever worship you. I can only imagine. I can only imagine. Oh, surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in awe of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak it all? I can only imagine, yeah, I can only imagine.
Registration for the 25th Ironman continues one by one. Some faces we recognize. Here is 58-year-old Richard Holcomb, number 214, back for a second try. He's legally blind and it doesn't matter to him. No, the thing that must occur at all costs is this time, cross the line.
It's more than a race. It's a lifetime event that we'll remember for the rest of our lives. They're either going to carry me off the course or I'm going to cross the finish line.
The stories about people like Richard Holcomb pass through this world as Race Week moves toward this morning. Hey, did you hear about the man who is legally blind? People love to tell and love to hear the stories. Then, appearing near the start line, where they've been before, are father and son, Dick and Ricky Hoyer. There is no one here who hasn't heard about them, their story, and a human commitment that goes far beyond and far back.
January 10th, 1962. We knew there was something wrong, but we did not know exactly what. The doctor said, forget Rick. Put him away, put him in an institution. He's gonna be nothing but a vegetable for the rest of his life. We cried a little bit. We talked, and then we said, no, we're not gonna put Rick away. We're gonna bring Rick home and bring him up like any other child. We knew Rick was smart. We could tell by looking in his eyes. And when we talked to him, he was paying attention to what we were saying. So we wanted to get a computer built so Rick could communicate with us. Everybody came to our house that night for Rick to say his first words. And everybody was betting, what is the first words Rick is ever going to say? His mom saying, it's going to be, hi, Mom. And me, the dad, saying, oh, it's going to be, hi, Dad. Well, the Boston Bruins were going for the Stanley Cup, and the very first words Rick ever said was, go Bruins.
Dick is a military man, so he knows a thing or two about commitment. This time, he's just months removed from a heart attack. This gift that he gives to his son, or is it the other way around? Either way, it all started when Rick heard about a charity run for a paralyzed athlete. He asked Dad, and Dad said yes.
The gun went off, and we went off with all the other runners, and everybody thought that Rick and I would just go to the corner and turn around and come back. Well, we didn't. We finished the whole 5 miles, coming in next to last, but not last. And when we got home that night, Rick wrote on his computer, Dad, when I'm running, it feels like my disability disappears. So that was a very powerful message to me, that we finally found a sport that Rick could get involved in just like everybody else. Is my motivator. He inspires me. To me, he's the one out there competing, and I'm just loaning him my arms and my legs so that he can compete. There's just something that gets into me when I'm out there competing with Rick that I can't explain it, and we're able to go faster. And it's just an unbelievable feeling. Rick and I love the Ironman triathlon, to be out there competing with the best triathletes in the world, to be accepted to compete along with these triathletes, just to be out there on that pier with all the other triathletes and then waiting in the water for that cannon to go off. It was just so exciting. The feeling coming down the finish line at Alihi Drive, it's just an awesome experience. With the crowd there, all the excitement, the noise, and the announcers announcing all that, your adrenaline just gets flowing.
One more time for Dick and Rick!
I may be disabled, but I live a very fulfilling life. And if someone takes the time to get to know me, they will realize that I am no different than anyone else.
Here he is. He graduated from public high school. He's graduated from college. He's out there competing in road races and triathlons. He lives a happier life probably than 95% of the population. Rick would tell you that, if he was physically able to do something, that he'd probably play basketball or football or hockey. But then he always says, no, the first thing he'd do is sit down and have me sit down in his wheelchair and he'd push me. It really makes me feel good that he appreciates, what I'm trying to do to help him out, and he'd do the same thing for me. Our message is, yes, you can. You can do anything you want to do as long as you make up your mind. You can do it.
If If you have ever searched for the meaning of life, stop. The answer lies right here.